And I was lying. No one's going home. That was just a rational deception to make sure you gave it your all in the tests.
Just for ya. Theme this month is school days. You know, school's back in session. School related stuff, probably some X-Men stuff in there. Whatever's related to school, I guess. Let's take a look. Ugh. Packing list. Let you know what's inside without spoiling anything. We'll get back to that later. Hey, we got a first covers trading card series. This is from April of 1983. Obnoxio. The Clown versus the X-Men. You know, I'm not a fellow that's really scared of clowns, but I could see where this would be really creepy for some people.
See that? Obnoxio. The clown's either holding, was that Kitty Pryde or Jean Grey? I can't tell. Seriously though, that's kind of creepy.
They gave us some Power Rangers cards. Feels like this one's got a Pog in there. If you don't know what Pogs are, I'll just go fuck myself. We did get a Pog.
Looks like it's the Sabertooth Tiger, if I had to guess. Was that the Yellow Ranger's Zord, Sabertooth? This is a Power Rangers villain called Shell Shock. However, tell me that that is not a straight up Teemu version of Toka from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Please, just a straight up Tyrannosaurus head. That's what it says, Tyrannosaurus. Tyrannosaurus dinosaur, skadoosh. Hilarious. I got the Putty Patrol. Dinozord versus the Megazord. Whoo! Big old battle. It's Ernie. Who remembers Ernie? Come on. Yep, it's Bulk. I've seen him at a couple comic book conventions. Just, you know, hanging around with Skull. Ah, Billy. Looks like a school photo. Lastly, we got this shiny hologram Rita Repulsa card. Neat.
On to the comic chest themed cards.
Baldy of all Baldies, Professor Motherfucking X. Old school Marvel Girl, which is just Jean Grey. I kind of like that this rock is taking up 60% of the card. Old school Angel, just, you know, flying around, because that's his power. Flight. Lame. Oop. I don't think I know this guy, but this is Husk? Yeah, not entirely sure I know Husk. Okay, it says here that Husk is the sister of Cannonball. Okay, well, I know Cannonball. You got the White Queen, Emma Frost. Very popular among the X-Men students, if you know what I'm saying.
Let's do a vintage figure. Oh, okay. Wow. We got a Ghostbuster here.
Dr. Peter Venkman. This is the Bill Murray Ghostbusters. From 1987. Give him a little bit of shade, huh? Yeah, Peter Venkman from 1987. He was a professor in that movie, so yes, this does fall in line with the theme. school days. Check us out. Crazy that it still works after all these years. Feel free to comment if this toy is older than you are.
Looks like we got some HeroClix. Do you know what HeroClix are? Well, let me tell ya. HeroClix are these mini action figures that go to a tabletop board game. You take a bunch of these mini action figures and you build yourself a team. Once that team's assembled, you go after your opponent's team. Once you reach your opponent's team, you battle it out by rolling some dice. Then you battle it out and you battle it out till there's one figure standing. And that is the winner of the game. HeroClix.
Yep, that's HeroClix. Floating around, we got Jewel. See this dial on the bottom? That's how you play the game right there. Got another floater, Killer Strike. See the detail in these things? So good considering they're so small. The Hulkling. He's like a kid or a teenager, but I'm pretty sure he's a shapeshifter. I don't know if he's full-blown Hulk. And Kate Bishop, if you watch the Hawkeye show, she's the new Hawkeye. I actually really enjoyed that show. I think it was fun. It was a great Christmas time show, you know?
We got another vintage figure. Let's open that. Dope. Shit, what's his name? All right, we got an X-Man of some sort. I can't remember his name right now. It's driving me nuts. Digging from X-Men 97 here. Is this Sunspot? Jubilee's little boyfriend? I think this is Sunspot, like the 90s version of Sunspot, right? This guy's cute little mask on there. Someone let me know if I'm right. Is this Sunspot? Also, he does a little bit of this action. There's backside. Yep, this is from 1994. Man, good shape for how old it is. 30 years. That's insane.
Now we got the vintage collectible. Oh, sweet.
Banshee. Do you guys know Banshee? Do you remember Banshee from, I mean, he was in, what, First Class? I'll cut to a clip.
I trust you. I'm touched. I don't trust him.
Say nothing.
I want to die.
All right, look, we're not going to make you do anything you don't feel comfortable with, all right?
Oh! Yeah! Eric!
Somehow screaming makes him able to fly. Okay.
There you go. Yep. Generation X. What year is this?
Unopened from 1996. So let's change that. Oh, hey. I got a blow pop.
I can't do the Banshee scream. I would.
I kind of got him fully stretched out for flying.
Screaming around so he can fly, you know? Came with a little X platform to stand on there. From what I can tell, it looks like Cerebro. I don't know why he came with Cerebro. That doesn't make sense. It's Cerebro turned into a gun? What? Okay, there you go. Sweet. Knowledge is power, am I right?
Then we get 10 comic books.
Got an X-Force comic with some, you know, kids hanging out on swings. Some chick hanging out on the swings with a kid. The City of Lost Children. I don't know, kid looks pretty lost to me, I guess. Check it out, comic grade card on the back, let you know what it's worth on the streets. Oh, speaking of which, you remember Cannonball? Cannonball's sister I mentioned earlier? That's Cannonball. If Cannonball can beat these guys up. Another New Mutants. Gossamer? Gossamer comes a-calling. Looks like the mutants have been turned into a checkerboard. New Mutants getting caught up in the Spider's lair. Sticky. Got an Excalibur comic. Girls School from Heck. All right. It's Nightcrawler. Hanging out with some randos. Looks like they're having a free-for-all, whatever that means. All right, I got another emo boy. I remember this. I forget how many of these I got from the comic chest already, but let's keep it going. Pretty morbid Generation X. Dude's holding the skull like a badass, pretty metal. Standing on the bodies of everyone. Another Generation X shockwave. People looking pretty serious. I like the costumes, pretty cool. Then we got an Ultimate X-Men. There's so many X-Men titles, it's hilarious. I want to say that's Jubilee blasting a Sentinel. Got some Angel action going on there. Again, he's whatever. Except for this other cover I got. Look at this cover. Just Xavier's Institute. This sucker is thick too. Almost looks like a full trade. Might be. Love this drawing. Beast looks fantastic. And Angel spreading those wings. Looks great. It's about all he can do, though. Till he becomes Archangel, he's kind of a little bitch.
That's a comic chest!
Awesome box. It kind of turned into mostly an X-Men box, which I kind of love. X-Men is the school of comic books, so I'm very happy with it. Love that we got some Ghostbusters action up in this shit.
Shall we recap? In this box, we got 10 comic books, one box collectible, two vintage action figures, a pack of HeroClix, and a pack of cards.
That had nothing behind it.
If you want a comic chest, I got links in the description. Hit them up. They'll work with you to customize a box if you want a custom box. Otherwise, just go with the monthly theme. They're always fun.
See ya!
Subscribe!